Hi guys, for this video I'm using yarn in two different colors. The yarn is in size 4 medium and the knitting needles in size 6 millimeters. You can cast on any way you know how. I'm going to cast on 40 stitches. I haven't knitted in so long, I forgot. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34, 36, 38, 40. So we have 40 stitches. Now for row 1, I'll turn my work around. And then I'll knit 1. Oops. Purl 1. Knit 1. Purl 1, knit 1, purl 1, knit 1, purl 1. So we continue knitting 1 and purling 1 throughout row 1. So this completes row 1. Now for row 2, I'll turn my work around and I'll start by knitting 1, purling 1. So it's just like row 1, it's just now we'll see which stitches we need to knit. When they look like this, we need to knit them. And when they look like this, we have to purl them. So we knit one and purl one throughout row two. So yeah, continue knitting one and purling one throughout row two. We will repeat row two until we have 12 rows in total. I have no idea how I stretched this stitch here, but I don't like how it looks. But I also don't want to go back and correct it. It doesn't look good at all. But yeah, we repeat row two until we have 12 rows of knit one and purl one. Now I want to use yarn in different color. Start by knitting this stitch because I want to tie this yarn. Now I will knit all the stitches throughout row 13. Just knit every stitch throughout row 13. Now I'll turn our work around, and again throughout row 14 we'll knit every stitch. Just knit one and purl one. You can knit any way you know how. So this completes row 14. Now for the rest of the pattern, we repeat row 14. We'll knit every stitch in every row to come. I'm trying to make something different to this one, but I don't know if it will work or not. Let's just measure it. We will continue knitting all the stitches until our work measures around 5 inches. So for next row, I will finish off the first 12 stitches. So 1, so we finish off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, so now we pass this stitch to our left needle. We finish off 12. I'm going to make sure to leave a stitch marker right here for the left side because we're going to finish that as well. Let's just see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And then we will knit these next 16 stitches. So now we knitted 16 of the stitches. We have reached this next stitch marker. So now I'll knit the first stitch, I'll knit the next stitch, and then I'll pass this first stitch over the second stitch. And then we repeat this until we have enough stitches. And then we repeat this for these last 12 stitches. Now I'll tie one stitch here, I'll chain one, and then I'll cut this yarn. We'll continue working through these stitches. Now, make a knot here to secure this yarn, a double knot. Okay. So yeah, we just continue knitting these 16 stitches. It'll be for quite some time. It depends how large your foot is. So we just continue these 16 stitches. And for how many rows, I don't really know. This is the first time I'm making this. I was planning to make it totally different, but then I had this idea and I want to try it out. And if it doesn't work, at least I'll just try something new. All right, so again, we're trying to work around and repeat the same thing. Just knit every stitch. I'll continue knitting the rest of this off the camera because basically it's just a repetition of knitting every stitch. I can't believe I made this mistake here. I got my stitch was very loose can't stop looking at it. Like looking at the wet beer.
So in every row, until I work, measures 10 inches from here to there. And in total, it measures on 40 and a half to 50 inches. I measured mine this way. Pattern is stretchy, so we got that going. I'm gonna finish off these remaining stitches now. So just knit the first stitch, then knit the next stitch, then with the left needle, we'll pick up this first stitch and pass it over the second stitch. Knit the next stitch, insert the left needle through this first stitch, and pass it over the second stitch. And repeat the same thing for the rest of our stitches until we have only one stitch left on our needle. Now I have only one stitch left, so I'll chain one and leave a long tail. Never made this one before, so I'm kind of curious myself if this will work out. I'm going to try to do this on the wrong side. All right, like this. We will join these two corners.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have 12 chains. So we weave this needle through each chain. We're going to close this loop now. Okay, it's closed now. We're just going to secure it. Chain one, we'll make a knot and we'll cut this yarn. Now we're going to repeat the same thing for this side right here. It looks like it's going to work. And for the left side here, we're going to have to close the loop the same way as we did on the right side. Knot again and cut this yarn. Now here for the back, as you can see, we have two colors. So with one color we join the bottom part. So we start right here. See those, the bottom part that we have just finished, see the knitted part. So I will add the yarn right here. Now I'll weave the needle right here through each chain. tighten it this way, and I will join both of those sides together. I'm going to switch the color for this first part. Okay, it looks small, but they have a lot of stretch. So this way, they measure 8.5 inches long. in this way, almost 7 inches. Oh my goodness, they're so comfortable. Oh wow. Warm and comfortable. Oh my gosh, guys, I didn't even know this was gonna work. Especially by the end, I was like, oh, what did I get myself into? But even the heel part, it's just so comfortable. This is really unexpected. Oh my gosh. My grandmother would usually take some strings and somehow twist the yarn and make the laces. I have no idea how she used to do that, but the socks always stayed up. She will weave them in on one side and then you just have to tie them. I have to ask my mom if she knows how to do that. But oh my gosh, guys, this is really comfortable. And to be honest, way better than I expected. It looks so small, but it has a lot of stretch. So it will probably fit sizes probably 7 to 10, if that makes sense, if not even different sizes, because it has a lot of stretch. This particular pattern has a lot of stretch. And if you want them to maybe be more secure, just make some laces and tie them here, weave them around this area. But I must say, I'm pleasantly surprised how this turned out.